the early 70s, the windsurfing hype was huge in Europe. Lakes and beaches were flooded with young men and women who were hooked on challenging the elements. Among them was a young Italian man, Claudio Brunotti. Traveling through Europe, Claudio Brunotti fell in love with the wind and the endless Dutch coast. In 1979, he decided to settle in Scheveningen, a city in the south of the Netherlands, right by the sea. He entered several surfing competitions and opened up a workshop at the beach. His experiments with shaping boards turned out to be a success, and Claudio soon started selling the boards to local surfers. It didn't take long before the colorful Brunotti boards and promo t-shirts were all over the place. Claudio decided to hire the young Jinna Sietsema to help him out in his workshop on Saturdays. Jinna turned out to be a real board-shaping talent. After many hours of fine-tuning boards and learning the tricks of the trade from Claudio, he became the main shaper at Brunotti. This allowed Claudio to shift his focus towards the clothing, and soon the collection, with a surfy look and Italian touch, took the market by storm.
Claudio Brunotti was really focused on details. He wanted to have everything precise. Sometimes when we were downstairs drinking coffee, Claudio was coming up, called me, "Jinna, you have to come up because there are some air bubbles in the polyester. We cannot make that to the client." So always he was controlling everything. The same with his, when he started to make the clothes, he always wants to have the expensive garments, materials for the clothes. Everything has to be perfect. And you can tell him always nothing, because it was always, "Hey Jinna, look what I make, eh? It's beautiful." Eh? It was always, and when other people bring something in, it was never good. And at the time in the 80s, the windsurfing was so big in Holland or in Europe. There were around 150,000 people here on the boulevard to looking at the windsurfing. And maybe there were more. It was really black from people. So many people were there on the beach. It was so big event. Windsurfing was, in that time, the shit, you know. It was like a big family. When you were driving on the highway, everybody was waving, because you're a windsurfer. All the lakes in Holland, full, full, full.
The brand grew steadily through the 80s and 90s and fully enjoyed the windsurfing boom in Europe. The clothing and lifestyle part grew bigger, and it was time for Brunotti to widen their horizon. Kitesurfing and snowboarding gained in popularity, and besides surfboards and beachwear, Brunotti started to develop functional and technical snowboard and kitesurf gear. When Claudio decided to move back to Italy, Jinna and the people surrounding him pushed the brand to the next level. Brunotti signed young, talented riders, and the Brunotti family expanded rapidly. It was time for exploring new markets. This is what we call the first dimension of the Brunotti era.
I think not a lot of people know that Kevin Langeray starts here, Ruben Lenten starts sailing on my boards. Now we have Yuri, of course. Then we had some good Dominican guys in the early kitesurfing business. They were really good. Susie May, a girl from also the Dominican, were all sponsored by Brunotti.
Especially for the team riders who show off their tricks at the highest level, Brunotti developed a special line called RDP. Products developed with the input of athletes that know exactly what they want to perform at their best. To deliver quality products, light, stretchy and durable materials for all kinds of weather and tested in the roughest conditions. The focus on team riders, on quality and RDP characterizes the second dimension of Brunotti. Meet Nick Jacobson and Yuri Zun, two riders with a lot of passion for their sport. The Danish Viking, Nick, is a total freak on the water, always looking for a different approach and crazy angles, while Yuri adds style and perfection to the world of kiteboarding.
Yuri is a good rider. He's got some style. He's got power, he's got pretty much everything it takes to be world champ, I think.
Yeah, my teammate Nick Jacobson, probably most of the people know him as a crazy guy. Well, that's what he is. The craziest thing about Nick is probably the crane jump that he did in South Africa.
Yeah, the crane jump. Climbing it, that was the scariest part, the most scariest part.
Déjà trop tard.
Ne me laisse pas l'aimer.
Mais tu l'aimes déjà.
Ne me laisse pas l'aimer.
Un jour, il fera mouche. Tu tomberas sur sa bouche.
Tu ne peux pas résister. Quand il vient te parler, je vois tes yeux qui s'accrochent à ses yeux. Non, tu ne peux pas résister.
Three decades ago, Claudio started Brunotti because of his passion for windsurfing. His small board shaping workshop turned out to be the beginning of an inspiring journey. Let's start the third dimension, a new era with a focus on all the good that the board sports lifestyle has to offer. Brunotti has deep respect for its roots, people, and the planet. Let the elements of Mother Nature define our future.
If I had to say something to Claudio Pranotti, I would say, great job.